Evan! It's really good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you too. It's nice to talk to the one person that I haven't let down yet. At least, not that I know of.
Oh, you haven't let me down at all. But tell me about this feeling that you've let people down.
I mean, what else is there to say? I've failed Jenna and the kids. For starters, we were really relying on both my paycheck and hers to keep us going. So money was already tight as it is. And on top of that, Jenna was really looking forward to going part-time just to be with the kids more. And we were really counting on my career to help us get through things long-term. But I messed that all up, and it's, all the pressure is on her now. It wasn't supposed to be like this. Really screwed up.
Oh. It can really hurt to feel that way.
Yeah, I've never felt this worthless before. Hmm. I mean, do you know what it's like to have to tell your family, your friends that you got fired? And I had a good job too. I really liked what I did, and I really see myself doing well and moving up. But I didn't stay on top of things, and I lost one of our biggest accounts. I mean, after that, even I would fire me. It's my own fault. The more I think about it all, the worse that I feel.
I hear how difficult this is for you. You lost a good opportunity, and you feel responsible. What steps or what do you see that you could help turn yourself around or move forward from here?
I haven't even begun to think about that. I mean, what company would want to hire me after something like this? I know I wouldn't want me. And even if someone did hire me, I'd probably mess that up too.
That's a lot of negative feelings to hold on to.
I mean, yeah, I mean, why wouldn't I? I had a good job, and I let things go, and now I can't even support my own family.
Sounds like this whole thing has really knocked you off your game.
Yeah, and I mean, the thing is that I know I made a mistake, but deep down, I mean, I know I'm not totally useless. I mean, I was doing a good job before I started slacking, so I know what I'm capable of. It's just I keep kicking myself for having thrown things away and thinking of how things could have gone differently. I mean, if I only hadn't messed this up.
You really seem down on yourself, but you said you know what you're capable of. So how do you see yourself, maybe see yourself or visualize yourself moving forward from here?
I don't know. I mean, I feel really lame just moping around like this. I mean, other guys I know that lost their jobs, they were out the very next day applying to new places. And me, I'm just throwing a pity party for myself. I mean, why can't I bounce back like they did?
Well, you might just need to get to take that very first step. Sounds like you want to change things. What do you think might be a good first step?
I wish I knew. I mean, I guess I can update my resume, right?
Okay. That sounds like a good start. In fact, that might start helping you feel better about things. What other possibilities would you consider? Would you consider seeing a career counselor?
I don't know about all that. I don't like the idea of counselors. They're not like you. They're not easy to talk to.
Well, I'm going to keep talking to you. But in the meantime, a career counselor can give you some resources and information that I can't. They're focused on helping you discover who you are, what jobs you're capable of, what strengths you have, and then they can pair you with a job that might be just a good fit. I just wanted to mention that.
Yeah, no, sure. I see where you're coming from, and I'll keep that in mind.
You don't have to make a decision tonight. Take your time and think about it. Decide what you want to do. In the meantime, what else are you thinking about?
I'm just really worried how we're going to pull through with things, with just the money stuff and whatnot. I guess I don't feel as hopeless about it as I did before. Mm. It's one job, and even if I did mess things up, that doesn't mean I can't get it right the next time. I don't want to give up on everything.
Losing a job is tough on anybody. But you're a capable person. I'm sure you're going to find another one soon. And getting your resume, booting your resume, revising your resume, I think might be a good first step. What do you think?
It has been a while since I've looked at it, but I know what to do. Mm-hmm. I used to help a lot of guys with their resumes in college, so I know what I'm doing there. I still don't know how I feel about the whole career counselor thing, mm-hmm. but I'll keep it in mind. I think I want to see how I do on my own, just job searching, and I'll make a decision then.
Okay, fair enough. If you want, I can check out our Stevens Ministry Community Resource Guide at church, see if they have any career counselors listed. If they do, I'll get that contact information for you. And that way, at least you'll have it if you want it.
Yeah, sure, that couldn't hurt. And listen, thank you so much for helping me think things through.
Yeah, sure.
I at least now have the start of a plan. I can't let this get me down.
You're welcome.
Good morning, Bridgeway. My name is William Jin. I'm associate pastor and also the director of care at this church. At Bridgeway, we have a vital care ministry called Stephen Ministry, or also known as Bridgeway Caregiver. It is the way that we could give care and support to those congregation members who need. We use Stephen Ministry as our base because it calls on the congregational care, lay people, to be trained to the one-on-one caregiving to those who need caregiving. Such as you have seen, someone who have lost a job, or maybe they're going through a divorce, or maybe they're struggling with illness. Whatever the way that they are facing the difficulty, we want to be there for you. We want to be there for you as a church and as a friend and as a congregation. So today, we show compassion in this church in three different ways. One, we tell them, you're not alone. Whatever that you're going through, we're going to be there for you. Second, whatever the little resources that we have, we want to share that with you. Sometimes it's not much, but it is our love and it is our heart. And the third, we want to share our hope and encouragement, not because we have something to offer, but we serve a God who is awesome. Amen? So today, and the reason why we're here is because we want to start this ministry. We've been trained since January for 14 of us. Every Tuesday night, we come together, we pray, we go through rigorous training in caregiving. And Dr. Anderson, we want your blessing. We want you to commission us so that we could go out and serve the congregations. And we're excited. We're excited that God has called into our ministry and how we can serve you. So with the leadership of this church, especially our senior pastor, Dr. Anderson, it means so much if you bless us and give us the commissioning so that we could go out and serve your people. Thank you.
Pastor Jin, first of all, thank you for your leadership over the care ministry. Can we give Pastor Jin a great big hand? And I want to thank each and every one of you caregivers who have gone through the training so that you can sit with folk in our congregation one-on-one to walk with them and to care for them. And so if the congregation would just extend a hand of blessing as I pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every one of these caregivers. Would you anoint them, bless them, keep them, watch over them. And Lord, would you connect them with just the right people at the right time in this congregation who might need a shoulder to lean on, someone to pray with them, a little bit of wisdom from the Word. And Lord, while they may not be professionally trained counselors psychologically, spiritually, Lord, they are there to walk with, talk with, pray with, listen to, and somehow shepherd under the covering of this ministry. And so, Lord, we thank you for each and every one of them, and we pray, God, that you would anoint them, that you would bless them, and we commission them now. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Together, Bridgeway said, amen and amen. Put your hands together for the caregivers. Well done. Well done. Thank you.